Gary, you went to Brazil, and you were having a healing meeting, and you heard God very clear fashion, and you probably did a double take. What did he tell you?
Yes, I did. He told me to take my shoes off because I was standing on holy ground. This was right in the middle of awesome time of worship. The presence of God was so strong in the room. It was just incredible. And my first reaction was, no, I don't want to do that because of the dirty, dusty concrete floor.
Did you try and talk yourself out of the fact that maybe that wasn't God?
Oh, yeah. I thought, well, that's just, yeah. So I continued worshiping, and then God spoke again, and he said, take your shoes off. And I thought, wait a minute. I think that's God, and I think I better do this. And so right now I reached down, and I took my shoes off. And thank God I did. Because I honestly believe that what followed would not have happened had I not taken my shoes off. You see, I believe that God tests us in the small things before he's going to entrust greater things to us. And that was a real test of obedience to see if I would respond to the promptings of the Holy Spirit. And as a result of that, taking my shoes off and responding in obedience, God opened my eyes. As I continued worshiping, I was looking up on the stage, and the dancers were dancing, and I saw three angels around the dancers, two of the dancers, and three more around two others, over to the side, a bunch of angels around each of the dancers, and I was just taken back with what I saw.
Yeah, but you had told me that you had, previous to that, been praying for God to open your eyes.
Yes. Because the desire of my heart when I went on the trip, because I was struggling, I'd been going through a difficult time, I didn't feel like going to minister, and I said, God, would you minister to me on this trip? I really need a touch from you. And my prayer was that God would open my eyes, that I could begin to see things from his perspective, not just my own.
Why were they worshiping? What was being accomplished? I don't understand.
The angels love worship. When we're worshiping God like that, the angels just come on strongly. The manifest presence of God increases dramatically.
What happened next?
Well, I was thanking God for what he did, though I didn't fully understand everything. And my heart's cry was, God, I just want more of you. I want more of your presence. And as I was worshiping him, and then I felt myself getting taller and bigger. And it was like I grew to 15 feet tall. Now, this church met in a large tent that seated 3,000 people. And I went all the way up into the top of the tent, and I was looking down over watching people worship. And to be honest with you, I got afraid. It was like there was a fear.
Should we have a fear, Gary, of the supernatural at times?
No, we shouldn't, but we do. Our flesh has difficulty dealing with the things of the Spirit oftentimes.
So you were being caught up into the heavenlies.
Well, because of the fear, I came back down. I started coming back down. And I thought God was taking me onto the throne room had I not resisted. I realized that God will take us as far as we're willing to go with him. There's so much more out there available for every one of us. My spirit, having been in the presence of God, when it came into my body couldn't contain it. And I was just thrown backward. I just had I was on the floor for about 45 minutes. And I want to tell you, I felt so little and so insignificant in the presence of an almighty God. I saw Jesus standing next to the throne with a scepter in his hand. The radiance, the glory of God was coming out of him. I had the look of terror on my face. I was in agony. I was screaming, but no sound was coming out of my mouth. And people around were afraid. They were wondering what had happened to me. Were you watching him?
I was.
What did you think?
I had seen God's power move on people, but I'd never seen him in a state of terror like that, because he just was never anxious. He's never been an anxious person. And so when I saw that look on his face, I got afraid. And I kept saying, somebody help him. Somebody help him.
There came a point where the evangelist, who's a friend of mine, Randy Clark, invited you to...
And he came over and he tried to talk to me, but I couldn't talk. And so he asked Kathy to come up and to tell what I had told her of what had happened. And as she got up there, she took the microphone, and then she began to explain what had happened. The Spirit of God, it was just like the power of God swept through that room. People began to cry out. They were falling to the floor. There were spontaneous healings that were happening. It was an amazing... It was like God's glory just filled that room, and she was testifying to that.
I'd like you to go to a video of Maria Black. See what happened to her.
Last year, we had a big forest fire in our area. After a few days, the fire department announced it, nothing they can do about it. The fire is so strong, so we were just waiting for a miracle. I was walking toward our living room, and something stopped me. And I felt something physically, and I looked toward our ceiling in our house, and all of a sudden, I saw the sky and five angels flying toward our area. They were all dressed in different color dress. They were very close to each other, like they were connected to each other. All of them had a bucket on their left arm, and rain was coming out under their skirt. And they were coming into our direction at 2 o'clock in the morning. My husband and me, we woke up, and that was the biggest rainstorm you can imagine, hitting our roof and raining all over us. And that particular rain totally put out the fire. By next morning, it wasn't any fire, any smoke, anything. Thank you, Gary, for this book.
You know, we spoke to the fire marshal from that area that she's talking about, and had that rain not come, there was no way that fire could have been contained. For just a few minutes, would you tell the average person how they can walk with an extraordinary God?
Absolutely. I believe these experiences are not just for us or just for a select few people at all. I believe that it's for the whole body of Christ, that every person can walk in that realm of the Spirit. The real key to this, in my opinion, is developing an intimate relationship with the Father, experiencing the manifest presence of God every day in our lives. That's the key to unlocking the heavens. We're so busy seeking power and more of the gifts, and God give me this, and God do that, God give me this, and we're not seeking His face. And as we just get, in fact, that's what I do. I get on the floor every day, and I just pour my heart out to Him. I confess my sins, ask Him to forgive me, I release all of that. And then I just wait, and I just say, God, I just want more of You, more of Your presence.
You've made a comment to me that there is an accumulative thing that is going on. It's sort of like, with me, opened to see angels at this point. Yet, we're on the same wavelength. However, I'm seeing something. I'm wondering if others are reporting this. I'm seeing extraordinary favor in my life. I'm seeing divine appointments. I'm bumping into people I have no way I'm supposed to be bumping into. It's sort of like, I do it first thing in the morning, and by putting God first and not asking for anything, getting clean, as you said, and being still before God.
That's our experience as well. See what happens when you come into the presence. You seek the presence of God every day like that.
More of Him, more of His presence. That's the beginning point. That's when He brings revelation to you. That's when your eyes are open to see in the Spirit. You begin to have visions, dreams, all kinds of supernatural encounters.
Gary, encourage me. Tell me about one person that went a period of time before everything opened up.
Yes. In fact, there was a pastor that was in one of our meetings, and he left disappointed. He said, you know, I'm just not one that's inclined toward this at all. I'm not mystical or anything. And he said, I got disappointed. He said, I wanted to see something. And 6 later, I got a phone call from him. And he said, Sunday morning in church, he said, during worship time, as we were worshiping God, God spoke to me. And he said, do you want to see something?
Oh.
And I said, well, yes. And he said, right then, God opened his eyes to a parade of angels coming toward him, one right after another. He saw healing angels, worshiping angels. He saw warrior angels. He said, my life has been totally transformed. I'll never be the same. And he said, but you know, he said, since that day that I left disappointed, he said, I began to press in for more of God's presence in my life every day. And he said, that's the key.